Welcome to NewsClick. Over the past few weeks, a huge controversy has broken out in the media space in Tamil Nadu. It broke out with the right-wing YouTuber Maridas leveling allegations that prominent journalists in Tamil Nadu were close to the opposition DMK and Dravidian and left political ideologies. He specifically targeted the channel News 18 Tamil Nadu. The channel and its editor, Gunasekaran, have approached the courts against his wild allegations, but an employee of the channel, Asif Mohammed, was asked to resign. In this context, we talked to Mr. R. Vijayashankar, editor of the Frontline magazine. Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Last couple of weeks, Tamil Nadu is witnessing some sort of turbulence in the media industry. So what is your opinion on this particular turbulence where the Sangh Parivar is waging an attack on the journalists who are very famous in the Tamil media?
I know. To understand what you termed as turbulence, you should look at the immediate political context. The political context is this. See, Dravidian parties, Dravidian movement has been ruling this state for the past 52 years without interruption. And they've been getting about 75% of votes. So they remain a very solid force. In this context, what has happened is in the last 2-3 years, what has happened is the Dravidian movement, if you take DMK and ADMK, ADMK, there is some criticism that it's not really a Dravidian movement. I will not go into it. But still, basic ideology, it arose from basic movement called Dravidian movement. So what has happened the last 2 years, two veterans, two big leaders of this movement, Mr. M. Karunanidhi and Ms. Jayalalitha, who were heading DMK and ADMK governments, alternately, they passed away. So now, the problem for BJP is BJP has emerged at this around the same time, just some 2-3 years before that, the BJP has emerged as a big All India party, first time coming to power at the center with its own majority. And now it says that it feels that it can really rule the country forever. And Modi is Har Modi, he's a real savior for the country. That kind of narrative they're developing. But what is happening is, despite all their proclamations about BJP being unbeatable, Modi being unbeatable, what is happening in Tamil Nadu, what has been happening in Tamil Nadu is, BJP is not able to really do anything to really enter this political scene. So this is the political context. They are trying every trick in their trade to gain a foothold. Actually, it can be called, you can't even call it a foothold because they're not able to get any votes. They try to manipulate. Finally, what they've done is after the death of Jayalalitha, demise of Jayalalitha, what they tried was, what they've been trying to do is to split the ADMK, weaken the ADMK, and through the back door, using the ADMK, capture the political space. That is the game. But even there, they are not able to do it fully because here, Tamil Nadu, people are able to see through this, the game. It is not a very secret game. It's not a very clever game. It's very, very unintelligent way of doing politics. That's what they are doing. And our chief minister and deputy chief minister, both are highly pliable. They are proven to be highly pliable. They listen to them. They act according to their wishes. And most places, even some ideological issues, they are willing to compromise, but they are playing, in a way, a kind of clever game of balancing between this, holding on to power, because they have 5 years of power. Nobody is willing to destabilize the government even within this. The split also didn't work, mainly because they are in power. They want power. So that is the whole game. So in this context only, the BJP is trying to do what we can call is through media manipulation. They can somehow change the entire narrative, entire socio-cultural political space of Tamil Nadu. And generally, people's outlook, you know, here, from this context, we should really understand what is happening to Tamil Nadu, what has happened in the last 100 years. Dravidian movement is there as actually it started, take Justice Party as the starting point. For the past 100 years, it is dominating. And its main achievement is social justice. Reservation is a major achievement. And they have really, even on the governance front, achievements of Tamil Nadu government are really highly appreciable within this Indian setup, Indian Union. They have done something in public health, education. That is one of the reasons why the party is a Dravidian rule is so strong here. So to break into this, BJP thinks that it can easily manipulate the media. Media strategy will work, but it's not just media strategy. BJP's basic problem is your ideology is completely antithetical to what is the mindset or the thinking of people in Tamil Nadu for so many years. So this is the context. So in this context only, they are trying to change the narrative, and they are intensified their efforts now because the election is just a year away. So this is the context. Next question.
Sir, in the last week, we have seen the ouster of a bureau chief from News 18. Yeah. And prior to that, there was a lead build up to this particular incident. He was linked to one YouTube channel which has the backing or supposedly the backing of the Dravida Kazhagam. And he was wrongly connected with this particular channel. And in other ways, he was literally forced to, or he was betrayed by the management as well. So do you think that some kind of state pressure has worked in this?
No, state pressure, as I told you, this is why I said the political context is very important. What is happening in media business in Tamil Nadu is there are families, there are newspapers, television channels run by some families traditionally for a long time. Of late, what has happened is some businessmen have entered the media business. So now it is easy for BJP to talk to them. You know what it means, business and politics, which, for example, BJP has succeeded to a large extent in capturing or in controlling the media, especially television media in North India, English channels. You know what, I don't want to go into it, except some one or two honorable exceptions. So in Tamil Nadu, the managements also, in a way, are not very firm in resisting any such moves. So what has happened is, this particular person, Asif, has been very active in fighting for media, that is journalist right, media freedom, and various aspects. He's an activist. At the same time, he's a professional also. See, the problem in Tamil Nadu is, though media houses are owned by, these dominant media houses are owned by businessmen who have their own business interests to promote, these anchors, if you look at the anchors, most of them come from a particular political or socio-cultural background, which is inevitable. For this to understand, for again, you go back to the Dravidian movement. In the past 100 years, the beneficiaries of this reservation, they have thrown up this backward classes. Scheduled castes have come up in a big way. So basically, Tamil intelligentsia consists of mostly Dravidian people coming from this Dravidian background, the intelligentsia, the educated section, that is dominant. Also equally good is equally are people with some kind of leftist orientation. This Dravidian and leftist orientation, some people, they think that they are together, they are one. Dravidian and leftist, both ideals, because left works on the political front or economic front. We work for the social front. We are for social justice, they are for economic. That kind of understanding is there. So then nationalist movement, Congress. So most of the people, educated sections, who constitute this intelligentsia in Tamil Nadu are from these three backgrounds, mainly Dravidian background. So naturally, when the new media, television media emerged in Tamil Nadu, most of the anchors and most of the journalists come from this background. So that is a problem. But the problem is, these journalists, these anchors, I know personally, that they are very, very professional. Very, very professional. Can there be a neutral person in the world? Can there be a neutral journalist? Is there something called neutrality? There is nothing. You take sides. That is journalism. You stand by the side of the underprivileged or the oppressed. That is the standard. So from that perspective, they can be called progressive leftist. Otherwise, they belong to various, or they believe in certain ideology, or they, in a way, they support some political party, but they don't show it in their shows. In my experience, I'll tell you what really has happened. The problem is that I used to go and participate in debates, television debates. Most of the debates, even before BJP comes to power, those days not many BJP representatives used to come there for the shows, for the debates. Later, just before Modi was projected as Prime Minister, or later after Modi came to power, BJP representative used to be there in the debate. Then what happened was, there'll be in a panel, there'll be one BJP person, there'll be one journalist, a liberal or progressive minded journalist, there'll be one person from DMK, Dravidian Party, or one from PMK. So all these parties, what really happened is, over a period, the BJP, because of its political and social ideology, they were seen as a minority. They think that they were cornered by others. I remember many BJP fellows, BJP spokesperson used to say, we have to answer 3 or 4 people at the time. But it's not the channel's fault. It's not the channel's, or it's not the fault of the anchor. It is your political ideology, your politics. You are getting isolated in this environment.
They were unable to
defend themselves. If it happens in Delhi, it may not be the case. So what happened was, later they started putting pressure on this management. What happened was, later in the panels, there'll be one BJP political representative, and there'll be at least two or three other people come in various disguises. Samuga Arvalar, social activist, or right-wing thinker, or auditor. All these people are basically RSS and BJP background. So in this context, BJP felt really miserable. So they started attacking the anchors. And anchors, actually the media houses, were very, very fair to the BJP, giving them representation more than, it's not proportional, it's more than proportional to their real actual strength in Tamil Nadu. But still, because of their own politics, narrow-minded politics, they were getting isolated. So anchors were targeted. Then they targeted journalists who were active. So this went to reached a crescendo recently, because again elections are coming. They also had their own in-house journalists who masquerade as senior journalists. They come in various names. They come as publishers, they come as auditors, but they are not able to match the panelists or the anchors' question. They're not able to answer most of the questions. So in this situation, they think that getting rid of journalists who are really progressive is the only way to capture the media channel. And some managements may also be willing to play this game, go along this. This is the context.
Sir, of late, the state government is also, you know, remaining very silent on the cyber attacks and abuses on the activists or the journalists who are participating in the debates.
Yeah.
So do you think that the ADMK government is, you know, playing into the hands of the BJP?
Yeah, that is why I gave you the first political context. The ADMK government now is surviving because it has a majority. But again, it's a disputed thing. There are a lot of problems. Even there is a defection and, you know, the split, and even High Court is inordinately delaying. Or that is a different issue. We'll not go into it. But ADMK government is playing the game which the BJP wants it to play. That is what is happening, because they want to be in power. They know that it is difficult to be without central government support. It's very difficult. Even at the cost of sacrificing their basic core values. So what they do is, they also play along. For example, I'll give you some examples. One comedian is there, I don't even want to name. He spoke very derogatively of women journalists in Tamil Nadu. Women journalists, because they use their feminine charms to get to the jobs. It created a media furor. And Hasif, who is now victimized, he is on the forefront of one of the agitations against this comedian. He's a comedian. I will not consider him as an actor. He's an actor, well-known actor, but he is even politically, he's a comedian.
A former MLA as well.
Yeah, a case was filed against him, but the problem is Tamil Nadu police, which is often compared to the Scotland Yard, they were not able to catch this man who was walking around in our public. He was present in many public functions involving former chief secretary. He is related to the chief secretary of. So this is the government. This is the kind of government we have. But at the same time, now they are taking action against one Karupar promoting enmity or promoting kind of disaffection against religion, some kind of thing. See, the problem, they are applying Gunda Act. They're invoking the Gunda Act. So ADMK government wants exactly the game that the BJP wants to play. So that is the real situation. Is really media freedom is under threat, because what they do is, this government, you know, these channels are dependent on one thing, because in the cities, at least you have private service providers. But Tamil Nadu, for the reach of the media, you need something called the government created Arasu cable TV. So one of the channels, actually, your media, your channel number is very important in the listing of Arasu cable or any service. Because you remember that name, no? You remember that number. The channel. What they did with our particular channel was to suddenly change its name, degrade it, take it somewhere else. So it's not visible. So that is how that kind of the kind of manipulation, the kind of unethical acts they are into, that's what they do. And even when there are complaints against journalists, there are complaints against people who have been really trolling journalists, women, attacking women in an indecent way. These people are not able to find them. Scotland Yard is not able to find them. They are present. See, we can see them everywhere. And the police. Also, the government is fully with the BJP government. And with the election around, we'll have to see how the game develops.
Another issue is of Hasif Mohammed, who was asked to resign. He has said that he was also being targeted for his union activities among media persons. Do you think his activism played a role here?
It is expected. Any media house, I don't think you can just talk about corporate houses. Others are a bit lenient. They don't act so harshly. But the problem is, in television medium, as I told you earlier, in Tamil Nadu, the dominant channels are run by big businessmen who are connected politically and economically. There are various connection nexus is working. This is very important. So first target of any management, not only media management, will be the union. And see, in Tamil Nadu, one negative side is union activity is not very strong. Hasif and others belong to small groups. There are some groups. There is no effective resistance in Tamil Nadu, which is not building up for various reasons. I don't want to go into, I know the reasons, but it's highly divided journalistic community in Tamil Nadu. But the problem is definitely Hasif is, your activity outside your office, your channel, and within the channel, this distinction has to be made. Was he a good professional? That should be the only criterion. Was he bringing news, or was he able to do analysis, or was he able to do good interviews? As far as I know, Hasif was a good one. Example I'm talking about. Even media anchors like Gunasekar and Karthiki Chelvi, they are all very good professionals. So the problem is, union activity is an easy handle for them. So union activity, that is the first condition any media organization or any organization will, though it is very weak, even that is seen as, and that is only a handle. See, it's only an excuse. They don't want him because he is very active. That is the issue. And they go into the background, political background, even family background of journalists, but final test, in that case, no journalist come into, no person in India can come into journalism if he belongs to a political family. How is it right? What are you doing as a professional, as an anchor, as an editor? That is more important than, that is a real test lies there. So this media manipulation or the activities against the media freedom comes from the central government, state government, and some pliable media organizations. And they also act, there are some instances of this BJP leaders telling anchors not to call some journalists or not to call these persons for the debates. And media managements also banned some people who participants in the panels. I don't want to mention names.
Yes, sir. One final question, sir. So yeah. The state is going to the elections in another 10 to 11 months. So the present desperation of the BJP is, do you think that the desperation is towards capturing power or capture the ADMK and in a way, sit in the power and do something?
As I told you earlier, BJP in Tamil Nadu is really acting in the most unpolitical, unintelligent way of, it is politics completely, it lacks imagination, it's bankrupt. So this only by riding piggyback on ADMK or split one faction of ADMK, they can do it. And they have some journalists also on their side. The problem is media debates and media landscape, media scape in Tamil Nadu is very active, mainly because there are so many progressive journalists here. By manipulating this, if BJP thinks that they can come to power, they can change the entire mindset of people, they can change the entire social justice platform, disrupt this upstage, that is completely change the narrative. It is not going to happen. Definitely it's not going to happen. And very interestingly, what is happening is, apart from BJP's complete isolation in the cultural and social world of Tamil Nadu, the real problem is the BJP's lack of a rigor, intellectual tradition. In my experience, when I go to debates, It's very difficult to counter people who have not read anything, who doesn't know history. They don't know science. They don't know their own history. We know better history of RSS than most of the BJP fellows. So the problem is, it is difficult to engage in a conversation with a person who is intellectually bankrupt. A party which is intellectually bankrupt. It has no tradition of scholarship. It's not the case of only Tamil Nadu. Look at all their debates. Look at the channels, the kind of debates, the kind of argument they put forward in every debate. Most of them, you will see that they are bankrupt. Intellectual bankruptcy is the hallmark of the BJP or RSS. Only emotional, they appeal to emotion. Right on emotion, which will not work in Tamil Nadu.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you for your time. Thank you.